Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. suspends classes in all levels in public schools as well as work in government offices until Wednesday due to the storm. Areas covered by the order are Metro Manila, Cavite, Laguna, Rizal, Bulacan, Zambales, and Bataan. The decision was made upon the recommendation of the Office of Civil Defense. We're on weather watch today as severe tropical storm Florita intensifies further. Signal number 3 is up in the northern portion of Ilocos Norte, mainland Cagayan, and the northeastern portion of Isabela. Heavy to, at times, torrential rains are expected over those areas. Meanwhile, several areas are under signal number 2, including Abra, Mountain Province, and Ilocos Sur, while signal number 1 is hoisted in other parts of Luzon. Florita made landfall over Maconacon in Isabela at 10:30 this morning. It's packing maximum sustained winds of up to 110 kilometers per hour with gusts of up to 150 kilometers per hour. Florita will continue moving northwestward before leaving the Philippine area of responsibility Wednesday morning. It's all hands on deck at the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council as severe tropical storm Florita continues to pound parts of Luzon with heavy rains and strong winds. The agency says 180 families in the Cordillera Administrative Region and Cagayan Valley were preemptively evacuated. At least 3 landslides were also reported in La Union and Albay. The agency asks those living in the path of the storm to remain vigilant and evacuate if needed.
Ating pong tinututukan yung mga areas po na landslide prone at flood prone dito po sa mga area na tatahakin itong bagyo dyan sa North Luzon. Kung matatandaan po natin, a lot of those areas po na binabagyo ngayon ay niyanig po ng earthquake, nitong nakalipas na Abra earthquake. Mataas po ang tsansa ng pagguho ng lupa dyan sa mga areas na yan, lalo na po din sa ating kabundukan.
More than 100 families in Cagayan have now been evacuated as rains brought about by severe tropical storm Florita causes flooding in several towns. Provincial disaster officials say COVID protocols are being implemented in evacuation centers. Relief goods have also been pre-positioned.
Nagulat yung ating provincial Social Welfare and Development Office ng food and non-food items. Nakahanda naman sila at naka-preposition ito sa mga warehouses nila sa Capitolio at sa Sub-Capitol. Anytime na may request yung mga municipal SWDO natin, we can make any release sa mga relief natin.